Hi guys, in the last video we started a new chapter called branch accounts, right? And we saw the concept of branch account, the structure of branch accounts, and we saw different types of method under different types of branches. And we started off with the first method, that was debtor system method. And in that method we also saw the format of branch account. If you haven't watched that video, please go watch that video first, right? Otherwise you will get confused. But if you're already familiar with the format and everything, then no problem, right? Never mind. Okay, let's go ahead. Now, here's the question. Let's go through it once and then we'll solve the branch account. So here we go. The Mumbai General Store sends goods to their various branches at cost. At cost price means this problem is based on cost price, all right? Then we have from the following particulars relating to Chennai branch. Prepare the necessary accounts in the books of head office. So here we come to know that the branch is in Chennai and the head office is in Mumbai. Alright, because this office is responsible for sending goods to all its branches. So this is the head office. Alright, then here we have stock on 1/4/2017. That's the opening date of the year, of the accounting year. So these are the opening balances. See, stock, debtors, petty cash and furniture are the assets. Right, so these are the opening balances of the asset which will be debited in the branch account. Then here we have creditors and bills payable. These are the liabilities, the opening balances of liabilities, because 1/4/2017, all right? So these opening balances of liabilities will come on the credit side of branch account as by balance B by D, brought down, okay? Then here we have goods sent to branch. Goods sent to branch means head office sends goods to the branch, right? See, in this question, the head office has sent 22,000 worth of goods. So this posting will come on the debit side of the branch account, okay, as two goods sent to branch. Then we have expenses paid by head office. See, now branch is an entity, right? So to sell the goods, to conduct the business, of course they will have some expenses. They have to incur some expenses. So those expenses like salaries, there may be freight, there may be sales expenses. So all those expenses will be paid by head office, all right? So here they have paid for these expenses like salaries, rent is there, and petty cash. Petty cash means like small amount of cash for stationery and daily purposes. Okay, so petty cash, 300. So these are the expenses incurred by the branch but paid by head office. These expenses will come on the debit side of the branch account as to bank. Okay, all right. Then here we have cash sales. Here we have cash sales and credit sales. See, cash sales means immediately the cash is being received by the branch, right? They are selling the goods to their customers and immediately they are receiving the cash, and that cash will be immediately remitted back to the head office, right? So on the branch, in the branch account, on the credit side, it will come by bank, and under that, cash sales, all right? 10,000 will directly come, but credit sales won't come, because under credit sales, we may not receive the whole amount of cash in that year only. For example, let's take this example only. There's credit sales of 25,000 here, right? So there is a chance that in this year, whole 25,000 wouldn't come. See, only 9,000 has been received. Cash received from debtors, only 9,000. See, they made sales of 25,000, but they received only 9,000, right? So whatever actually they received, right? Whatever actual cash they received, that you have to take into the branch account. I will show you that, okay? Don't worry. Now here it might look confusing, but while doing the branch account, I will explain it to you in detail, all right? Okay, let's move forward. So what I said, cash received from debtors will take into the branch account. Then we have sales returns from debtors, discount allowed to debtors, and bad debts. See, these three items and this one credit sales item, these four items will not take it into branch account. We'll take this, we'll adjust these in the debtor account, all right? And then we have goods returned by branch. See, goods returned by branch means sometimes the branch wouldn't be able to sell some goods. So those goods will be returned by the branch back to the head office. So that returns by branch will always be credited in the branch account as buy goods sent to branch. Okay. Then we have stock on 31/3/2018, petty cash on 31/3/2018, and creditors on 31/3/2018. So all these are the closing balances, all right? There are closing balances of assets as well as liabilities, as we saw above. But here there is a slight difference, all right? See, here we have stock, above also we had stock, right? And the amount may change, okay? No problem. Whatever amount is given, we'll take that. See, here the amount was 8,000, but here it is 10,000. It doesn't matter, okay? Whatever it is given in the question, we will take it. Alright, then we have petty cash, 200. But here, before petty cash, there was debtors, right? So debtors is not there in the closing balances, right? That means we have to prepare. Okay, it is so mandatory now that we have to prepare the debtors account to find out the closing balance of debtors. Okay, then they have also not given us the furniture. See, here there is furniture, here there is no furniture. Alright, so that also we have to find. We have to see why they have not given us the furniture closing balance. Then we got creditors and bills payable. That is same. See, 3000, 2000 and the above also 3000, 2000. So don't worry. You just have to copy paste that. Alright. Okay. Then at the last they have said write off furniture by 10%. That means there is a depreciation here. They have said to depreciate the furniture by 10%. Alright. We'll see that. It's easy. It's simple. Okay. You just see it. Alright. Okay. Fine. Now let's solve this problem through debtor system method. So here we have summarized question, which we will use whenever we feel the need of question while solving. So under debtor system method, first we need to prepare the debtors account. Now most of the question you will have to prepare the debtors account, alright? But how to know that when you need to prepare the debtors account and when you don't need to prepare the debtors account? See. Three things are very crucial to prepare the branch account, which are connected with the debtors account. Okay, see, first is cash received from debtors, right? We should know how much cash the branch actually received from the credit customers, the debtors. All right, and the second thing is, and the third is the opening balance of debtors and the closing balance of debtors. All right. So here we don't have the closing balance of debtors. It's not given in the question. The opening balance is given, but the closing balance is not given in the question. So we have to prepare the debtors account to find out that. All right. So how will we find out the closing balance of debtors? I will show you. All right. See, the debtors account. We prepare debtors account to find any of those three, four things. All right. That's the purpose of preparing this debtors account. See, in the question, we have here the opening balance of debtors. So that we will take it over here to balance, because all the assets will always have a debit opening balance. We also have here credit sales, don't we? So whenever we sell goods on credit, our debtors increases. So if asset increases, we debit it. All right. Whenever asset increases, we debit it. So the credit sales will always come on the debit side, right? To credit sales. How much? Credit sales is 25,000. So 25,000 will come on the debit side. Then we have here discount allowed and sales return and bad debts. So these three items are also connected with the debtors, right? Discount was given to debtors, sales return, the debtors, the credit customers who took our goods on credit, they returned their goods, right? So all these are connected with the debtors. So this will come, all these will come on the credit side, because they reduce our asset debtor. All right, debtors. All right, then we have here cash received from debtors. Cash received from debtors means the debtors paid their debt, they paid their debt in this year. So that will come on the credit side because it reduces the debtors. If they paid their debt, then there will be less debtors left, right? So it will come on the credit side. The simple rule is that, is it increasing or decreasing? If the debtors are increasing, we debit it through that. If debtors are decreasing, then we credit it. All right, then yeah, everything is over, right? The opening balance we got, credit sales, and all the discount allowed, sales return, bad debts, and then cash is also we got. Okay, then we will total it. We'll find the balancing figure. Okay, I'll keep that aside. See the balancing figure. 25,000 plus 4,000, which is equal to 29,000, right? This side is of course shorter, right? So we'll write this on the both the sides and we'll find the balance. 29,000 minus 9,000 is equal to 20,000 minus 500, 400 and 100. That is equal to 1,000, right? 1,000 minus 20,000 is equal to 19,000, isn't it? 19,000. So 19,000 would be our balancing figure, which is by balance, C by D, carried down. This is the balancing figure. So we prepare this account just to find out this figure. Alright, by balance C by D. This will be our closing balance of the debtor's account. Okay, alright. So our purpose is fulfilled of preparing the debtor's account. Now, after preparing the debtor's account and finding out the closing balance of debtors, after that we need to prepare the main account, the branch account. So to prepare this account, we need to see the question here. And this account, this branch account, is similar to the consignment account. We saw the consignment, right? If you haven't seen the consignment account, don't worry. See, branch account is similar to trading and profit and loss account. It's a nominal account. We record all the expenses on the debit side. All the expenses on the debit side and all the revenues on the credit side. Alright? So, let's begin. Okay, so first thing we will do is we'll take all the opening balances of assets. See, the assets are stock, debtors, petty cash, furniture. So these four assets. So we'll take all the four assets here, all right, as two balance B by D. Two balance B by D. And one by one we'll write it. So we are done with the opening balances of assets. So always we will debit the opening balances of assets. Whatever assets are given in the question, only those assets we will take. Alright? You have to take the total of this. 8,000 plus 4,000, which is equal to 12,000. 12,000 plus 6,000, 18,000. 18,000 plus 500, so it is equal to 18,500. Alright? Okay. Then next, you have to take the liabilities. See, here there is liabilities, creditors and bills payable. Opening balance of liabilities, you will credit it on the credit side. Alright? That is equal to by balance, you will take it like this, by balance, it's credit side, right? So by balance brought down, and bills payable 2000, which is equal to 5000, right? Okay, after that, in the question, if you see here, there is head office, right? So head office has sent goods to branch costing 22,000. So that entry, that posting will come over here. Two goods sent to branch, or you can also write the short form GSTB, but in the exam I will recommend to write the whole thing. Okay, two goods sent to branch, which is equal to 22,000. So 22,000. All right, and then there is expenses paid. The head office has paid the expenses of the branch. I've told you while explaining the question that always head office pays the expenses of the branch. All right, whatever the expenses branch incurs, it is paid by the head office. So those expenses are debited in the debit side because it's a nominal account, right? We debit all the expenses. So it will come like this. It will come like this to bank. All right, because the bank account of head office is reducing. Okay, so to bank, and whatever expenses are there, salaries is there, rent, petty cash, all you will write it below. It's equal to 3,300. All right, then if you see over here, see, sales is there. Sales, there has been cash sales of 10,000. The branch has sold goods on cash basis costing 10,000. All right, so that will come over here by bank. Now the cash, whatever cash the branch is receiving after selling the goods, that cash will be remitted back to the head office. In the previous video, in the concept, we have seen that the head office sends goods to branch and the branch sell it, and after that whatever revenue it receives, that revenue is remitted back to the head office, right? That cycle I told you about. Yeah, so that revenue, whatever it receives, right, cash sale through cash sales, it will be remitted back to the head office. So here cash sales 10,000, right? So 10,000 directly we will take. Then we have here credit sales. Now credit sales means that cash is not received on the spot at the moment, right? The customers are promising to pay in the future, right? So the entire cash amount is not received. So the entire cash amount may not be received in this year. So here, look here, cash is received only 9,000, right? So only that amount we will take over here. Whatever cash we have, that cash only we'll send to the head office, right? So we will take here cash received from debtors. All right, the debtors, whatever cash we receive from debtors, whatever cash we collect from debtors, only that we can remit it to the head office, right? So we'll take cash received from debtors 9,000. All right, it's given in the question, but we not take credit sales. Most of the student make this mistake. They see cash sales, credit sales, directly they will take it over here. No, you don't have to do like that. You have to take cash received and cash sales. Okay, whatever cash the branch has, only that cash will be remitted back to the head office. All right, this is over. All right, and these items will not come into the branch account, that is discount allowed, sales return, bad debt, because we have already adjusted them through debtor's account, right? Okay, so this is over. And then we have goods returned by branch. So goods returned by branch will come on the credit side. Okay, buy goods sent to branch, buy goods sent to branch. See, this is the opposite posting of this one, to goods sent to branch. Okay, here the branch is receiving the goods, here the head office is receiving the goods. You see, these are the opposite or vice versa entries. So how much? 800 worth of goods. So 800. After that, everything is over, right? Everything is over. So now we will close all the balances. See, here we have assets balances. Now we are going to take here all the assets closing balances. See, now closing balances, first we have stock. Okay, let's take that. Buy balance C by D. All the closing balances of asset will be credited. Okay, buy balance C by D. First we have stock. How much? 10,000. All right, whatever is given in the question, that you have to take it. 10,000 is given in the question, so I took it. Then debtors we found it, right? See, debtors we found it, the closing balance, right? Balance C by D, 19,000. We found that. So that 19,000 will come over here. Debtors. This was the reason to prepare the debtors account. All right. Okay. Then we have here petty cash. So petty cash is 200. So 200 will come over here. And then we have furniture. But furniture, look here what they have said. The opening balance was 6,000. Then they said write off furniture by 10%. So we have to write off the furniture by 10%. 6,000 into 10%. How much? 600, right? So we will deduct 600 from 6,000. How much we will get? So the furniture would be 5,400. Why 5,400? Because it is 6,000 minus 600. There was a depreciation, right? Okay, fine. The assets are over. Stock, debtors, petty cash, furniture, all the assets are over. Then next we have the liabilities. Liabilities will come on the debit side. To balance C by D. All right, the liabilities are creditors and bills payable. So in the question, they are as it is. Okay, they have not changed. The opening and the closing balances are same, so we'll take it as it is. Creditors and then bills payable. So 3,000 plus 2,000, all right, 3,000 and 2,000. So everything is over. Opening balance, closing balance of assets, opening balance of liabilities, closing balance of liabilities, to goods sent to branch, and whatever the returns came from the branch to the head office, those returns also be credited. And then the sales are also over, cash sales and cash receipt from debtors. And then the expenses which were paid by the head office, that also we took, right? So everything is over. Now we will find the balancing amount. Now how to find that? See, which side is bigger? Now if you check here, this side is shorter than this side, all right? This side is bigger. So we'll add up all this, which is equal to 59,000, which is equal to 59,200. Okay. Sorry, 59,400. All right, 59,400. So the same thing we'll write over here also, 59,400. After that, we will deduct 59,000 minus 59,400 minus 2,000 minus 3,000 minus 3,300 minus 22,000 and minus 18,500. All right, I have already calculated here, so it is 10,600. Okay, 10,600. So if there is a shortage on the debit side, then it is profit. All right, so we'll write to profit and loss. In the bracket we will write profit. Okay, simple, right? It is very simple. This branch account, this method is the simplest method that you can find in this chapter. All right, easy, right? Okay.